Hello everyone, welcome to day 2nd of December lead code challenge, and today's question is linked list random node. In this question you are given a singly linked list and you need to return a random node value from the linked list such that each node has equal probability of being chosen. Very simple description of the question. The question is based on the reservoir sampling problem. I'll explain about it as we go through the algorithm. Let's go through the example first. So in this example, you are given three nodes, 1, 2, and 3. You need to devise an algorithm such that the probability of choosing 1, 2, or 3 is equal. That means 1/3. Get random should return 1, 2, or 3 with equal probability, equivalent to 1/3. So you need to write the algorithm for this and define get random method and initialize the solution class. So let's jump onto the algorithm now. Let me just start the slideshow. And it's a typical mathematical problem. If you are aware of reservoir sampling in general, well and good. If you are not, don't worry, I'll explain it here. So let's take a linked list. The linked list starts with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this is the null node. Let's forget about the rest of the nodes and let's only treat that the linked list has one single node. So if the linked list has one single node, what is the probability of choosing that element? It's 1. 1/1 is 1. And hence, you are 100% sure that you are going to choose that element. If there are two nodes in that element, what is the probability of choosing 1 or 2? Either 1 or 2. It's 1/2. And how can you represent 1/2? 1 into 1 by 1 into 1/2. I'll explain what I am trying to portray here. If you take three nodes, and 1, 2, and 3, what is the probability of each node? 1/3. And how 1/3 can be represented? 1 into 1/2 into 2/3. So the probability of selecting two nodes, 1 and 2, into probability of selecting the new node, that is 2/3. I'll explain what I'm trying to operate here if you are confused about it. I'm just writing a mathematical formula here and I'll tell you why I'm doing that ways. If you have four node, then the probability of choosing 1, 2, or 3, or 4 is 1/4. And how can you represent it? 1/1 into 1/2 into 2/3 into 3/4. So that these two cancel each other and three cancels each other and what you have in the end is 1/4. So if you understood this expression, how we are writing it, then you are good and you'll be able to understand the algorithm. So let's move on to the algorithm. Before that, let me just tell you, there is a random Java inbuilt method, and there is a class there is a public method that is exposed by random class that is generate next integer that generates all the numbers from 0 to k-1, where k is an upper limit, k is not included in it, is from 0 to k-1. And what I have written as an algorithm here, so let's iterate through the algorithm. For I equals to 1, till the time list pointer is not null, you keep on incrementing I. That means it will move as many number of times as there are nodes in that linked list. So what I have done, random dot move the linked list side, that's a generic statement for iteration. If random dot next tint of I is equal to I minus 1, I am resetting the result to the link pointer value. Now let's explain how it works. So let's take an example where the first node has the value 10 and the linked list is having only one node. So I in this case is 1. Get random of next will generate 0 and is equal to I minus 1. That means it becomes true and result is set to 10, which should have been the case. The probability is 100% now. It's 1/1. And 100% you'll get 10 in the result. Let's assume we have 10 again. After 10 we have 7 there. The second node is 7. So during the first iteration, I is 1. Random next will generate 0. 0 is equal to 0. Result is set to 10. Now let's the second iteration. I is equal to 2. Random dot next int can generate two possibilities here. 0 or 1. So let's consider case 1 where 0 is generated. So 0 is not equal to 1. That means result will be set to the previous value what have been set, that is 10. So this statement won't be executed and the value won't be updated. For the other case, the probability would be the probability for generating 0 is 1 by 2 and that of 1 is again 1 by 2. We are pretty sure about that. And in this case, I is equal to 1, I is equal to 2, and if we encounter case 2, 1 is generated out of it, then 1 equals to 1 and the result will be updated to 7. That means that the probability of choosing either of these two cases is 1 by 2, and what you do, you multiply it with the probability that was previously calculated, 1, and hence probability for choosing 1, probability for choosing 0 as an element, it turns out to be probability of choosing 1, the probability for this case, that is 1, and probability for choosing 0 is 1 by 2, hence probability for choosing 0 is 1 by 2. If you still have confusion, let's take another example. So case 1 is clear to you, I is equal to 1, result equals to 10, I equals to 2, 0 and 1 can be generated, and the probability of choosing the first two elements is 1 by 2. We are pretty sure about that. Let's talk about when we have 9 there, the third element there. So I equals to 3, random.next int 3 will generate 3 numbers, 0, 1 and 2. For case 1 and case 2, the value won't be updated. So if I talk about what is the probability of getting 10 or 7, that means 1 by 2 into 2 by 3. So probability of getting 10 or 7 is 1 by 2 or 2 by 3, which equivalents to 1 by 3 altogether. If you understood this concept, you almost reached the answer. So what is the probability of getting probability of getting result as 10 is 1 by 3. Probability of getting result as 7 is again 1 by 3, because 1 by 2 into 2 by 3 is 1 by 3. And obviously the remaining probability is 1 by 3, because the first two probabilities are 1 by 3, 1 by 3 itself. So 2 by 3, 1 minus 2 by 3 equals to 1 by 3. And hence each is having an equal probability of 1 by 3. I hope I made it clear how we are evaluating the probabilities here. Let's quickly code this up. So defining a list node head equals to null, random, equals to null. Initializing these two, this dot head equals to head, and this dot rand equals to new random. Writing the algorithm now, integer result equals to minus 1, list node t equals to head, for integer I equals to 1, I is less than, t is not equal to null, I plus plus, so number of elements in the linked list. If rand.next int of I is equal to I minus 1, if that is the case, then let's update the result with the current node's value, t dot val, and update the t pointer to the next node, return t, return res, sorry. There has been a typo here.